very happy with the result of the quarter with indeed a record organic growth of 23% and very strong growth for all our divisions, perhaps with the exception of the APAC division. And that strong top line growth and of course gave us good volume leverage also boosting our bottom line. And if you take the bottom line and exclude for acquisitions and currencies, we were at 15.9%, and that would have been a similar level as we had prior to COVID-19 in 2019.
You may have heard before we started this interview, I was speaking to another guest, an economist, and we were talking about rising inflationary pressures. And there's one part there that seems to pop up when we speak to many different corporates, and that is of supply chain pressures. So I'm just curious to see how supply chain pressures are affecting a company like yours and whether or not you've been able to pass on the extra costs to your consumers.
Well, that's of course true. You see very strong material cost inflation, and you see that inflation for all materials, copper, nickel, zinc, aluminium, you name it, and definitely also for steel, where we have seen very strong material price increases. If you take, for instance, steel in the US, steel prices today are 200% up compared to the same period a year ago. And that's, of course, almost, it's not normal inflation. You could say it's hyperinflation. And of course, we compensate for that through other cost-saving measures in our operations, and mainly also through price increases. We have done several pricing increases. As steel price continue to increase, we continue to increase our prices. And so far, we have been able to compensate to a good extent for those material inflations. In Q2, our headwind from material versus price was only 20 base points negative on the result. And that's something we will continue to do now also in the second half, those price increases.